So challenging. Best combined time of male and female. The qualifying heats leads to the finals. Best combined time there wins the finals. To tell you what can happen in this thoroughly testing event, here is Billy Crystal.
Okay, here we are at the obstacle course, which is probably the most difficult event because it combines speed, endurance, and pure rhythm. See, it's a lot of agility. I had probably the most memorable run at this course 2 years ago. Remember? Okay, the key is to get a good start. Please remember, don't leave your upper lip on the top rope. Watch where you step in the tires. I learned that from running in Central Park. Grab all the handlebars, then get a good jump at that wall. Up and over, don't leave any of your knee on the top of that fence. Coming off there. And if you're hot, hit the water, just like I did. Tumble around and make sure you finish. And then search for your upper teeth.
Billy Crystal, a remarkable demonstration of how not to run the obstacle course. The women's heats are already underway. Judy Norton Taylor of CBS with a great time, 19.92. Here's Billy Crystal again.
Well,
yes.
You've run this before.
Yes.
And you've won it.
Yes.
But now Judy's time of 19.9, it makes a lot more pressure on you, doesn't it?
Yeah, but I think with the adrenaline going in the competition, I might go a little faster.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I'll need it.
And you're running against a veteran over here. Okay.
Yes.
I'm going to walk over to that veteran if I don't trip. Kristy, you are a veteran. You can't deny it. You're a veteran at such a young age.
No, I'm getting old. I'm older now.
You think that's going to make a difference in a race?
Maybe. I don't know. I'm going to try hard.
You hold the course record.
Do I really? How many seconds?
How many seconds?
I don't know. She did
19.9.
That's fast.
Do you think that your new size is going to make a difference?
Maybe
you say you're growing
bit.
Up.
Older.
You think it's going to make a difference?
Just a little bit. Not much. But I'm not as fast as I used to be. I know that.
Well, let's
But I'm going to try to be
19.9.
young again. No?
You got to beat it. Good luck.
Thank you.
Not just a great athlete, but a great actress. There she is, accepting her second Emmy just recently.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and now in a different scene set, a different motif. It's Melissa Gilbert going against Kristy McNichol. Two of the young ones getting ready for the second qualifying heat, the obstacle course. Remember, Judy Norton Taylor already with a 19.92 second time. A big time to have to beat. But Kristy McNichol, already the record holder in this event for women. And they're ready to take off. If they run it like Billy Crystal, they'll both wind up in the tank. Here we go. Waiting for the starting gun. Both girls poised, the gun off. Kristy McNichol getting up a quick early lead. Working the lifesavers, as you call the tires, very well. On the handlebars, Kristy McNichol with a possible penalty, but Melissa Gilbert in real trouble. So Kristy McNichol off by herself. Handles the water hole easily. Kristy McNichol with a quick and easy victory over Melissa Gilbert. Look at the determination on her face. Why don't you handle a slow-mo, Bill?
Okay, well, I thought that was a penalty on Kristy. You have to grasp the last rung, but obviously it wasn't, so she's going to have a great time. Here's poor Melissa struggling. She had a blister on her hand before the competition. She's having a rough time. A great race for Kristy. Let's go to Howard for the official time.
Here it is! A brand new record! Whoa! 19.56, the official time, but an injured Melissa Gilbert walks off. This young woman, who's grown up on Little House on the Prairie, is very important to the society. Near Palm Springs is Children's Village USA, a children's residence center dedicated to abused and neglected children and their families. What's important is the time and efforts Melissa Gilbert volunteers with the children. Here she is.
Okay, now let's make a big, long nose. Now he looks like a... When we first came here, the little ones hardly had any idea of who I was. All that I was Melissa. One little girl said to me, "You're beautiful because you're a long-headed woman." I said, "Why?" She meant my hair, because it's long. And another one, they're so loving. They all say, "I love you." And the one says, "You give much love." Little girl with the curly hair says, "You give much love." I love it here.
Hey, look out.
I want to live here. You ready? Don't fall. Oh, please don't fall. I like little kids, and I like working with them. And they're just little babies, some of them. Some of them are older, but they're basically just like all other kids. If I were to give them some advice, I'd tell them to be happy and enjoy what's going on around them rather than seeing all the bad and everything. Because people who grow up saying, oh, this was terrible, that was terrible, this is bad, that's bad, will never have any memories and will always lead a very depressed life. Whereas a little kid who grows up saying, oh, wasn't that fun and wasn't this fun and remember the time when, will always grow up being a happy person.
You and me against the world. Sometimes it feels like you and me against the world. When all the others turn their backs and walk away, you can count on me to stay. Remember when the circus came to town and you were frightened by the clown? Wasn't it nice?
Tender thing, a tender feeling. Not all of the children abused. Some daycare center kids, and Melissa so great with them. Now we're ready as we go back to the competition, to the third women's qualifying heat in the obstacle course event. Valerie Bertinelli, one day at a time against Erin Gray. Buck Rogers, 25th century, and they are off. Nearest to us, Erin Gray and Valerie Bertinelli in the far lane. They negotiate the tires, like lifesavers, we said. Now the monkey bars. Erin Gray with that live, supple body, getting a quick lead. Now over the fence. But Bertinelli, a veteran in this event. She knows what it's all about. The water hole. Erin Gray still in the lead. Bertinelli pouring it on, getting the lead at the finish and winning the qualifying heat.
What a finish. What a great race, Valerie. You should each congratulate. What a finish. She did come from behind.
She
to
sure
nose
did.
You out. I heard you tell Billy Crystal you were kind of psyched out going
I really
into-
was, yeah. Right now, I'm just about to faint, but don't mind me.
Second time around. That's what you did last year when you were hurt.
Oh.
But you gave it a terrific errand.
Thank you. Oh,
terrific
thank
effort,
you.
Really. First time you've ever faced that.
Yes, very first. Thank you. You were great over that leap.
Yes.
I couldn't believe you made up that time.
Neither could I.
And she won it at the very end, at the water jump, and then the final burst that brought her past you. It was terrific, really.
It was a lot of fun.
Proud
really
of you
I'm
both.
I'm glad it was you and not Kristy.
<Me too. laughs>
Well, you should both be congratulated by the team captains.
Who called it? Who's calling what? Huh?
Looks like there's a penalty on Valerie. It's a shame. It's one thing to run a lousy race and lose like I did, but to run a good race and be disqualified is a shame.
Witnesses on the side have said that they saw the same thing he's doing. One calls up. Okay, it's a call.
Captain Asner, what is the problem? You're watching a penalty?
Inefficient judging.
What? In
That's
what
right.
way?
Well, Kristy slipped on the last bar just as Valerie did on this bar. Valerie was caught. ABC is mouthing off.
All right, in slow motion, Valerie Bertinelli, the far lane. Let's look at it. And as she gets to the final rung on the monkey bar, just touched it, did not grab it. Quite apparently a good call, a penalty.
Howard, here's Christie's now, and we're at a different angle. Now watch her as she comes to that last bar. She does grab it. So it's not a penalty. Christy, I'm sorry.
Commissioner Brett, what do you say?
Well, the commissioner, after hearing rumors that Kristy McNichol did not touch the last bar, I went over and talked to the judge. She said she did grasp it. I was standing there when Edward's partner came over the last one. I saw her just slap at it. She didn't grasp it, and in the rules you say you have to grasp it. The one judge said that Kristy grasped it, and this one she said she didn't grasp it.
Poor Valerie. But net-net, the finals, Judy Norton-Taylor against Kristy McNichol. The obstacle course finals coming up, men's division. It will be Greg Harrison of CBS against Willie Ames of ABC. But first, the women, Judy Norton-Taylor against Kristy McNichol. Here's Billy.
You set a record in that lane, and now you've chosen to run in this lane. Any particular reason?
No. No.
I've never seen you more determined for anything in my life. This is
I love sports. So.
Well, good luck.
Why.
I'll get
Thank
out of
you.
Your way.
Okay.
I'm going to go over to Ms. Taylor, who ran a great race. Judy?
Yeah.
Yes. I thought we would. You're running against the record holder.
I know.
Ran a great time yourself, and it's going to be a great race. How do you feel?
I'm twice as scared as I was the first time.
Did you think that the competition would be this strong, that the sense of competition for you would be this intense?
I knew Kristy was good, and I knew she was going to be the one to beat on this event. She's done it before. She's quick. She's young. She's small. She's got everything going for her, and she doesn't make mistakes. So it's going to be really tough.
Well, you didn't make many either. Good luck. It's going to be a great race.
Thank you.
Judy Norton-Taylor, been with the Waltons from the very beginning. Let's meet this remarkable young woman, a great athlete, a gifted actress, up close and personal.
I'm not into the Hollywood scene whereby, you know, it's like the Friday night Hollywood parties type things. I'm not that into that side of the business that much.
Well, she is some athlete. Look at her working out with the Los Angeles Thunderbirds, the roller derby, the way she uses the elbows. She is going to be some tough cookie for Kristy McNichol to beat in the finals of the obstacle course. And now we're ready for the start of the race. Judy Norton-Taylor right before you, the far side, Kristy McNichol. They're off. Kristy McNichol with a quick early lead, navigating the tires perfectly. Judy Norton-Taylor falling behind. Now the monkey bars. Did Kristy clutch that last rung? Our view obscured by Ed Asner. But Kristy McNichol off by herself. Kristy McNichol again with an apparently quick and easy victory.
Kristy, you did it again. And
you're done in, aren't you, kid, huh?
I don't know.
Great race. No
Thank
pain
you.
This time. You didn't hit me.
No pain.
Where is Judy Norton-Taylor? Let's get her over here. She deserves congratulations, too. Where is she? Is she all right? Is she all right, Captain Asner?
Is she all right?
That was a tremendous effort. It wasn't until that last fence that you fell behind.
She's good.
Congratulations to you.
Thank
she is
you.
Good. It's amazing. I'm waiting on the official time.
For Kristy McNichol, her time, 19.206.
Wait a minute. A penalty.
Wait a minute.
A penalty lodged against Kristy McNichol. Now, let's get those official times again. The penalty lodged against Kristy McNichol, so she winds up at 22.20. And Judy Norton-Taylor at 20.41. So, CBS is presently leading in this event with Willie Ames yet to go against Greg Harrison. Let's get the official nature of the penalty from Commissioner George Brett. George, what happened to bring about the penalty?
Well, when Kristy McNichol went over the monkey bars, Howard, she did not grasp the last bar. She just kind of slapped at it and didn't put her hand around it. And when you do that, you're awarded 3 seconds. penalty.
No wonder Ed Asner has become such a great sportsman.
Ed is very competitive, and you got to have competitors out here to have a lot of fun.
Okay. Thank you, George. So there it is, at the moment, leading in the event, CBS, because of the penalty against Kristy McNichol. And so we're ready for the start of the men's finals. That's Willie Ames of ABC. And he's got a lot of time to make up in view of the penalty against Kristy McNichol. And of course, going against Willie Ames, Greg Harrison of CBS, who has been a superb all-around athlete in this competition from its very inception. Ready now for the start. They're off. And look at Willie Ames go under there and develop the early lead. He maneuvers through the tires very well. Now the monkey bars. Greg Harrison now ahead of him, over the wall. And tremendous trouble for Willie Ames. It'll be an easy victory for Greg Harrison, off by himself. CBS the winner.
Well, Willie, good effort, but this guy is spectacular. And so, you should give him congratulations, Valerie. Greg Harrison with a brilliant performance, winning the obstacle course event for CBS, net-net. Willie, Bob, do you know what the score is now in the whole of the competition? NBC with 300 points, ABC with 300 points, and with a great comeback, CBS with 300 points. So we have a three-way tie.
You couldn't ask for a greater competition up to this point. And next coming up, the running relay. And what an event that's been in the past.